The Government Healthcare Plan. Page 22 mandates the government will audit all books of all employers who self-insure. Page 29, lines 4 through 16, healthcare rationing. You can only receive so much care per year, $5,000 per individual, $10,000 per family. Page 30, section 123, there will be a government committee that decides what treatments and benefits you receive. Page 42, the healthcare commissioner will choose your healthcare benefits for you. You have no choice. Page 50, section 152. Healthcare will be provided to all non-US citizens, illegal or otherwise. Page 58, the government will have real-time access to your finances and a national ID card will be issued. Page 59, lines 21 through 24. The government will have direct access to your bank accounts for elective funds transfers. Page 65, section 164. This is a payoff subsidized plan for retirees and their families in unions and community organizations such as ACORN. Page 72, lines 8 through 14. Here the government is creating a healthcare exchange to bring private healthcare plans under government control. Page 84, section 203. The government mandates all benefit packages for private healthcare plans in the exchange. Page 85, line 7. AARP members, your healthcare will be rationed. Page 91, lines 4 through 7. Government mandates linguistic appropriate services, or translation for illegal aliens. Page 95, lines 8 through 18. The government will use groups like ACORN, AmeriCorps, to sign up individually for government healthcare plan. Page 102, lines 12 through 18, Medicaid-eligible individuals will be automatically enrolled in Medicaid. Here you have no choice. Page 124, lines 24 through 25. No company can sue the government on price fixing, and there will be no judicial review against the government monopoly. Page 126, lines 22 through 25. Employers must pay for health care for part-time employees and their families. Page 127, lines 1 through 16. Doctors and the American Medical Association. The government will tell you how much money you can make. Page 145, lines 15 through 17. All employers must enroll employees into the government plan. You have no choice. Page 149, lines 16 through 24. An employer with a payroll of $400,000 and up who does not provide the government option will pay an 8% tax on all payroll. Page 150, line 9 through 13. Any employer with a payroll between $251,000 through $400,000 who does not provide the government option will pay a 2 to 6% tax on all payroll. Page 167. Any individual who does not have acceptable health care coverage according to the government will be taxed 2.5%. Page 170, lines 1 through 3. Any non-resident alien is exempt from individual taxes. You and I will pay for them. Page 195, officers and employees of the Healthcare Administration will have access to all Americans' financial and personal records. Page 203, lines 14 through 15 reads, "The tax imposed under this section shall not be treated as tax." Page 239, lines 14 through 24. The government will reduce physician services for Medicaid. The seniors, the poor, and the low income will be very affected. Page 241, lines 6 through 8. all doctors, no matter what specialty, will be paid the same. Page 253, lines 10 through 18, the government will set the value of doctors' time and professional judgments, literally the value of human life. Page 265, section 1131, the government mandates and controls productivity for private healthcare industries. Page 268, section 1141, the federal government regulates rental and purchase of power-driven wheelchairs. Page 272, section 1145, regarding the treatments of certain cancer hospitals, cancer patients, welcome to rationing. Page 280, section 1151, the government will penalize hospitals for what the government deems preventable readmission. Page 317, lines 13 through 20, prohibition on ownership and investment. The government tells doctors what and how much they can own. Page 317 through 318, lines 21 through 25 and 1 through 3, prohibition on expansion. The government mandates if hospitals can or cannot expand. Page 321, lines 2 through 13, hospitals have the opportunity to apply for an exception, but community input is required. Page 335, lines 16 through 25, and page 336 through 339. Government mandates establishment of outcome-based measures. Healthcare the way they want it. Rationing. Page 341, lines 3 through 9. Government has authority to disqualify HMOs, forcing all into the government health plan. Page 354, section 1177. Government will restrict enrollment of special needs individuals. Page 379, section 1191, more bureaucracy. The Telehealth Advisory Committee. Page 425, lines 4 through 12, government mandates advanced care planning consultation. Seniors will be interviewed every year for health issues and decisions made as to what care they can and cannot receive. Page 425, lines 17 through 19. The government will instruct and consult regarding living wills and durable powers of attorney. This is mandatory. Page 425, lines 22 through 25, and page 426, lines 1 through 3. Government provides approved list of end-of-life resources guiding you into death. Page 427, lines 15 through 24. Government mandates program for orders for end-of-life. The government has a say in how your life ends. Page 429, lines 1 through 9. An advanced care planning consultation will be used frequently as patients' health deteriorates. Page 429, lines 10 through 12. Advanced care consultation may include an order for end-of-life plans. An order from the government. Page 429, lines 13 through 25. The government will specify which doctors can write an end-of-life order. Page 430, lines 11 through 15. The government will decide what level of treatment you will have at end of life. Page 469, there will be community-based home medical services, such as ACOR. Page 472, lines 14 through 17. There will be one monthly payment to such community-based organizations. Page 489, section 1308. The government will cover marriage and family therapy, which means they'll insert government into your marriage. Page 494 through 498, the government will cover mental health services, including defining, creating, and rationing those services. If you care about the health of your family, your parents or grandparents, we urge you to contact your representative and ask them to oppose this bill. Don't be fooled into believing that this is an affordable option. This is mandatory, not an option. It's not free, and it comes with a $2 trillion price tag. Most importantly, educate yourself and read the bill.